This is the start of our trip. We just got out of Hanoi and we're now pretty much into the countryside where the roads are beginning to open. And we just bought this bike here called a Yamaha Serow 250cc from supposedly a reputable source. It's the only frame size we can find that will fit her, but it's having some carburetor problems already, so we'll see about that later. And then I'm on the standard XR 150, which is a bike we often do. Yeah, this is the beginning of what should be a pretty cool trip around the north. We'll see how it goes. Found anything?
We'll have a 3-star.
3-star, wow.
Yeah, 3-star. That's Bac Kan, it's the big one over there.
Sounds amazing.
Alright, go to 3-star.
You reckon they gave themselves the 3 stars, or is it an official certification? Three stars it is. It better be a good 3 stars. So we've just left Cao Bang town. Basically we didn't leave yesterday until around lunchtime, so we didn't get to where we wanted to go. And today we're off to the northeast border of Vietnam to China to go to Bac Kan Waterfall or something. I'll try and get the real name later. Anyway, it's the limited research I did. I didn't find really anything about this waterfall on the foreigner English websites, but it's certainly on the Vietnamese blogs and things, it's all over the place. So for Duyen over there, it was what she really wanted to see was this waterfall. So it's always good to get it, the roots from a local perspective, often over the English perspective. So I don't think there's going to be many foreigners there, if any at all, but knowing my research will show up, there'll be some tour buses. And this morning, had the good old beef noodles, and out of nowhere the lady popped out some perfectly ice cold Coke, just like you'd expect in a 5-star resort where the water was perfectly condensed on the outside, you know, the real advert style. Coke advert, that was just lovely. So we just left the town of Cao Bang. What is it? What?
Okay.
And we're going where?
Cao Bang.
And Google Maps is saying it's around 4 hours, so that probably means 6 to 7 in real life. Just arrived at Ma Bay Lake, driving down. That's pretty spectacular.
Amazing lake, but it's just tours. You go on a boat and they take you around.
Take you around. You can do a whole day thing between 150,000 and 800.
But I think for us, we just want to drive, so we're gonna head on to the waterfall. This is our initial plan. But yeah, what an amazing place.
What's the waterfall we're going to see?
Cao Bang, yep.
Cao Bang, yep.
Bang, yep.
Why are we going there?
To see water.
To see water. Is it beautiful?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
Welcome to Bang Yup Waterfall. This is it. Ooh, look at that.
Close as I can get.
that's how you off-road, just like that. Look at that tire.
Driving around trying to tighten the chain on my XR. Should have been replaced in Hanoi really, but we left in such a rush. And the Honda shop doesn't have the tools to take out a chain link, so we're now just driving around trying to find someone who does. But it's been raining since 12 last night, all the way this morning, so it's now like around 10:30, so we're leaving a little bit late, and we have a pretty massive drive ahead of us to Meo Vac, so we need to get going. Good news is we had a big breakfast. I managed to find a pizza for breakfast. Duin had a steak. So we're good to go for the rest of the day. Just got to get this chain sorted out or it'll fall off somewhere in the mountains, and then we'll be in real trouble.
Day.
Yesterday, before heading out, no more off-roading, she said. Today, we had a choice between the longer QL34 and the shorter looking DT something or other. I warned her that this DT is going to be something like this. Anyway, we ended up on the DT. Here we are.
That's what happens when you don't look where you're going. China.
That's one, not Chinese. They are, yeah. China, Vietnam, this road.
Ah.
China over there with the valley there. That road is China. You can see the beautiful houses down there. They keep extracting them.
So the Chinese are invading Vietnam.
Yeah.
God damn it. It's Chinese, it's got nothing to do with you.
More and more mountains, you.
So we're just leaving the town of Meo Vac and we're heading to Ha Giang. And supposedly this is going to be one of the greatest pass within Vietnam, but I've already forgotten the name, it'll come up later. Not much to say about Meo Vac, not a lot happening there. But as you can see today, we have absolutely picturesque weather. We are so lucky. The route's pretty straightforward along the highway. From all the sort of tour guide maps and whatnot I've downloaded, they all seem to agree the highway is the way forward. So nice and simple today. This is now our fourth day, and we've been hitting around 7 hours a day per day, so beginning to feel a little bit tired. But this drive should be a good one. So just had an update called the Pi Leng Pass. And according to Duin, the people around here are not speaking Vietnamese. Minority groups. You are here. Number 5. Stretch. time to go to Lao Cai and do the good roads around there. It's tonight, another 4-day loop or so, and we need to be getting back. So we decided to head south today from Haiyang. And the road today so far, it's around lunchtime now, although not that interesting, very, very quick. Got a highway empty. Already in just a couple of hours, we've racked up 130k, which is not that far off what we managed to do in the entirety of yesterday. It's very quick driving. The track is to try and find this homestay. We gave them a call to see if they had space or could expect anyone, but nobody answered the phone, so they're going quite a long way out the way in the hope that this homestay actually exists. So we'll see what happens, but we're driving through a very nice countryside village road at the moment. Booked a boat tour to go in this lake here, but the guy's just where?
Kappa.
And he's just realised that his boats are all filled up with water, so now he's having to deal with this crisis and dilemma. Let's see what the solution is. So he's got a solution to the problem. We'll get there. We'll get to the lake. I don't know what we're gonna see in the lake, or if the boat will survive. But that's okay. I'm a professional swimmer. Yeah. So they're working hard. That's why they put spells on them, so they can hear them from them. Damn, they are smart. Always a solution for every problem. 9.